Hey, this is Douglas Smith. I'm broker owner, DHS Realty, and it's about 10 o'clock on Thursday, and my wife and I, we had gone downtown, got our will situated, in case anything ever happens to me or her, how our estate is passed on to our kids. It made me just kind of put my life in perspective at that moment as we get to more serious things in life. And I've already had a will, but this is more of an updated will. And just wanted to leave something for people to know who they're working with when they deal with me. Really for my kids, once I'm gone, they'll always have this somewhere on social media. And so I just wanted to tell a little bit about my story and what got me to where I am today. So I was born in 1969, and about 2 years after I was born, my parents thought it'd be a good idea for me to look out a window on a second story that had a window up and a screen loose. I fell out two stories, broke my skull. I've had a number of operations. I've had bone grafted from the inside of my skull on the back of my head and put on the outside right here. I went through a few years where I wore a hard helmet that had my name on it. Said Doug, D-O-U-G, a white one, a blue one, and a red one with a strap. My mom thought it'd be a good idea for me to have a portrait made with that. I don't know if that was a good idea back then. Still have it today, so it does give me a reminder of where I've been. But really, I wasn't supposed to be alive. Doctors didn't even know my skull was fractured. At one point, I had a plate, had wires in my head. Always one show and tell once I had that plate taken out and my own bone was grafted. And now I have a complete skull where it's bonded together. But I learned early on that humans can be brutal, that you can be made fun of. I think I established my thick skin from those early years as a young adult. And basically that was kind of the life I led all the way up until, you know, high school. And I decided to play tennis. I used to hang out at a tennis court almost 24 hours a day when I lived in Sherman. And my eighth grade year, the high school tennis coach came to all the middle schools to have kids try out for ninth grade freshman team. And I went to Dillingham in Sherman, and no one made it from our school that end of eighth grade year. I remember that summer I took lessons from a girl up in Sherman named Whitney Charlton, and took lessons every day. And the first ball that I hit trying out before ninth grade started, we had another tryout. The first ball I hit, Coach John McGee said, if I could put anybody in Wimbledon right now, I'd put you in it. And it was the first time that really anybody had ever poured into me with some confidence. And I had to kind of have it on my own. And to this day, my last dying days, whenever that will be in the future, I'll remember that quote that he said to me, that saying. And we had a very good friendship, and I really looked up to him as a mentor as I was in the high school years. So anyways, played a couple years of tennis there, and we moved up to Sherman. My dad, I had a restaurant that went out of business in a bankruptcy, so we moved up into Sherman. He got his license, and I went off to college. I was there in San Marcos at Southwest Texas State University. I was there for 4 years, graduated, was an RA for three of those years, and was an English and a philosophy minor when I graduated. And when I graduated, I really didn't know what I wanted to do, a lot like the four kids that I have. And I decided to come back and work as a bank teller for a few months, save money. And one day I just came home with a ticket to Europe and told my parents I was going to go backpack on my own for about 45 days. They thought I was crazy, and I didn't care. And I went anyway. And I slept on trains at night. I think I stayed in a hotel one night, shared it with a girl from South Africa that I met on a train. And I was there for about 45 days in the heart of the winter, and had a backpack and a pair of jeans and some thermals underneath those. And I think I took one shower over 45 days and learned a lot about myself and learned a lot about people. So anyways, that was kind of the start to me marching to my own drum and taking the road less traveled. When I came back, I applied to, I think, 35 law schools and got rejected from every one of them, basically. I did get accepted to one, but it was a two-year deferment, and it was up in Michigan, Thomas Cooley School of Law, and decided not to do that. I went into oil and gas, and really, I found that I was at home in sales. I actually applied for a job out of the Dallas Morning News and got a sales job in sales, raising money for an oil and gas company. McCullough Eberhardt was the investment firm, and Weber Energy was the oil and gas company. And they drilled horizontal wells and in LaGrange County. And I really succeeded in that job. I got the Pit Bull Award my first year for tenacity and fortitude and determination, got the most new clients, learned to get even thicker skin selling oil and gas. And I really fell in love with the idea of never having a ceiling. So my dad, who was a Remaxer at the time, he told me that I should get my real estate license because there's no ceiling. He just forgot to tell me that there's also no floor. And I learned that pretty quickly. So when I got my real estate license, right out of the gate, I was a hustler. I called expires. I dropped packets off. My dad and I started doing home buyer seminars. And my dad, his name's Mal Smith. He's with Competitive Edge, a competitor. It's a great company. Look him up on Facebook or all the social media platforms. But anyways, at the time, he was a Remaxer. I joined Remax and worked there for about 23 years and paid a lot of office dues and fees and splits, and there was caps, and I just never went to the office. I've always been kind of somebody that like to be told what I can't do, and then I like to go prove I can do it and take pictures doing it. So I never went to the office except when they'd call me to check mail. I'd go up and get my mail, throw it away, and then I'd leave for another 30 days or so, and kind of got involved with city politics, Parks and Rec Board, played a lot of tennis, just wanted to succeed doing my own thing. So my dad and I worked together for a little. We worked on our own as well. We both learned a lot from each other. And in 2002, after 9/11, I decided I wanted to either go in the military or somehow provide service back to our country after the events of 9/11. So I became a volunteer firefighter in Frisco for 5 years. And at that time, I also got divorced and had full custody of my daughters. I had two daughters, Ashley and Lauren, and had them every day for 3 years, except 2 weekends where their mom had them on a Saturday and Sunday. I was told by many, including family members, I couldn't do it. I couldn't volunteer, do real estate, and be with my kids every day. And I said, watch me. And I did it, and I took pictures doing it. It was a time in my life that I would not trade for anything, and fell in love with the fire service and also doing real estate. And I've had family members say that you can't be part-time and full-time. And I've never believed in those labels because there's 40 hours that define a full-time worker. And in 2 days, you have over 40 hours if you didn't sleep or if you decided when you wanted to work. And I decided that I wanted to have multiple jobs. Being a dad is obviously full-time firefighting. I did that every third day, even as a volunteer, which I only needed to go every sixth day for 12 hours. I ended up going every third for 24, and also did real estate, and I loved it. After about 5 years of doing that volunteering, I took about a year and a half off, and then I decided I loved it and I missed it. I'd hear engine sirens going down Preston Road, and I missed it. So I decided to go back full time also and get my firefighter certificate and my paramedic license, and continue to do real estate and be a father, which is the number one job in my life. And right about 2007, after being with Remax, I also fell in love with my wife, Shannon, and we got married, and she had a 7 and 9 year old, and I had a 7 and 9 year old. So we now have 2 22-year-olds and 2 20-year-olds. And about 6 years ago, my dad started up his company, Competitive Edge Realty, which is a great firm. And I helped him very sporadically. Again, how much I helped him is up for debate. So I also fell in love with teaching after my wife listened to me do a home buyer seminar, thinking that nobody would listen to me for 3 hours. Told me that I should apply for some teaching jobs. So I applied at Champions and also at Collin County Association of Realtors, and decided I wanted to take the move and go with Champions, and it's been the best decision ever. I just love it. I feel like I have multiple homes in my mind, in my heart, where I feel at home, and one is with my wife and with my kids, and obviously real estate, and when I'm in front of people trying to give them a little bit of knowledge that they can maybe take with them, and it'll make a difference. And I like to live my legacy. I don't want to die and just say that he left one. So I try to live it every day. And I know with certainty I'll die one day. I just want to know that I've left it all, and that I won't have any regrets, and I've sucked all the marrow out of life. So that's kind of the business plan that I had after I decided after 5 years I wanted to start my own firm. So I started DHS Realty on January 1st. And we're at our year anniversary, and have about 220 agents, and just absolutely live it, breathe it, bleed it, love it. Can't think about doing anything else. Love to talk in front of people and have them take anything that might be free advice from me that they can use in their own life. And but I also realize that, you know, you got to live your own dream. And so when people call and want to move on to a different brokerage firm, I wish them luck. And when people come on, I tell them that I'll provide them all the tools for success. But you do have to have hustle, drive, and a determination and fortitude and tenacity and never give up type of spirit. And you got to also have a balanced life. So that kind of brings us full circle to the last year. And we've had a little commercial department established, and we have a couple great agents that are heading that. We have a firm that has a lot of leaders in it. There's no one leader in this company, but the sum makes the leadership. And just super excited about what the future holds for us in 2022. So we're going to have a meeting tomorrow on Friday. And in that meeting, we're going to talk about our vision. We're going to do a little work seminar on working with a buyer A to Z. And I just want all the agents to know that inside of 12 minutes, I've given them kind of my life story. I hope they know that you know, nothing easily won is heavily valued, that life is a struggle, there's valleys, and I always have liked the saying where you're either in a valley, coming out of it, or going in it. And I'll always be there for the peaks and the valleys. So y'all be safe, have a great one, and that'll conclude 12 minutes.